Ladies, gentlemen, I don't know about you, but honestly, this is my favorite time of the year because I get to sit down with the actors whose performances, whose work I've most enjoyed, and I get to sit down and talk to you all. So thank you for those incredible performances, and welcome to the Actors Roundtable 2022.
Thank you so much.
You know, I want to start with a question that I want all of you to weigh in on. In each of your respective shows or films, what was that one scene that you performed that reminded you why you love what you do?
I think for me, it's easy. The whole climax of Badhai Do. Uh-huh. The last 20 minutes. Because for me, that was the most important and the most responsible part for Shardul. Because that would have decided where the film would go. And for me, that was beautiful. I think the way Harsh, that day on set, the way Harsh has created the whole environment on set, everybody was just so quiet because we just wanted to achieve it right. Mm. And it was just one take, not much. And I'm just so happy. I didn't even see my take on the monitor. Just, you know as an actor that, you know, something happened.
Right.
I was there. I was truly there. I think, yeah, that's
it. Is the pride scene?
No, the pride, just before the pride scene. Right. The terrorist scene and the way.
The phone call. Yeah.
The day when he comes out in front of the family.
Yeah. Oh, gosh. Hard. Yeah. Oh, lovely. Daljit Paji?
Jo ki film mere liye ek film nahi thi, wo Sikh genocide pe ek statement thi, jisko abhi tak dange ya sirf rights hi kaha gaya hai. To ek aise platform pe Netflix pe ye baat kahi ja rahi thi jo Ali Abbas Zafar direct kar rahe the, aur ye Sikh genocide ke bare mein baat ho rahi thi, chahe 1% hi baat ho rahi thi. To mere liye ye is movie ka part banna isliye bahut zaruri tha. और मेरे लिए बहुत अहम थी ये फिल्म क्योंकि ये जहां से मैं आता हूं ये वहां की बात करती थी
बिल्कुल
तो इसलिए मैंने वो फिल्म देखी
पाजी एक कोई ऐसी सीन थी जो शायद दूसरे सीन्स या दूसरे पोर्शन से ज्यादा आपको आपके लिए बहुत ज्यादा मायने रखी थी
जी एक बाल काटने का सीन था उसमें तो वो मेरे लिए बिना टर्बन के फिल्म करना ये भी एक चैलेंज था मुझे ऐसा पता नहीं था कि कोई एक्सेप्ट करेगा उसको कि नहीं करेगा लेकिन ऐसा एक्चुअल में हुआ है ये कोई मिथ नहीं ऐसे कोई कहानी बनाई हुई नहीं थी ये सच्ची बात थी बहुत सारे लोग ऐसे हैं जो अभी तक जिनको ना तो इंसाफ मिला है और उनकी लाइफ अभी भी डिस्टर्ब है और अपनों को खो दिया गया है और इसके बारे में बात कम हुई है तो वो सीन बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट सीन था और वैसा हुआ है तो मेरे लिए वो भी टफ था
और वो सीन बहुत बहुत दर्द का सीन है जब जब वो एंड ही डज इट फॉर हिज फैमिली ही डज इट बिकॉज़ ही इज मेकिंग दैट सैक्रिफाइस
जी जी
बढ़िया सीन था
थैंक यू
तरुत्मा
दिल्ली क्राइम ना
हां मोस्ट अगेन
किससे आई वांट टू मेक श्योर
किस्सा के बारे में बात करते
हैं एक्चुअली इन दिल्ली क्राइम because my character is on the wrong side of things I love playing the scene where she comes into this place that she's going to create her salon and because we have such a simplistic look in life generally that these people are good these people are bad ye acche log hain ye criminals hain but aadmi criminal kaise banta hai what makes him what pushes him there So I love the scene where she comes out like any other woman, walks into this space and imagines her future, where she's cutting hair and it's her space and she has a dream. I love that scene because I feel in that moment, you see that yes, she's a criminal and she's done things that are wrong. But like all of us, like any one of us, she has dreams. You know, and that felt very nice because I knew that my character is going to go on to do horrible, gruesome things.
Right.
And it was nice to have that moment of, as just the dreamer, as like any other.
Yeah. I kind of second what Tilotama just said. To be able to play a person who is very unlikable, take that chance and risk and put yourself out there because you believe in the story.
Mm.
For me, Darlings spoke about domestic abuse, spoke about a terrible marriage and to see a woman suffer like that and to and as an actor to put yourself out there honestly, truthfully, knowing that this can trigger a lot of people. Actually, a lot of women got triggered and things from their life erupted and they went through major emotional crisis while watching the film, including myself and Chef. When we first saw the film, it was difficult to watch. But when you tell these stories, it's important that it's spoken.
Yeah.
इसके बारे में बात होनी जरूरी है. जैसे दिलजीत भाई ने बोला अभी कि इन मुद्दों के बारे में बात होना बहुत जरूरी होता है. और बात उस बात में आपका अगर योगदान होता है तो एज एन एक्टर यू फील दैट यू आर डूइंग द राइट थिंग.
Was there a specific scene, Vijay?
It was a nightmare all along. Yeah. But I remember there was one scene in which I come back. I found out that she's probably cheating on me with Zulfi's character, Roshan, played by brilliant Roshan Matthews. I come back. Hamza is very angry. He's looking for her inside the house. And that entire conversation where he's like, I gave you all the freedom. I don't make.
Well, she's in the kitchen. She's in the bathroom.
Yeah.
She goes she's hiding in the bathroom.
And he's thinking ki in dono ka affair chal raha hai. And we had to improvise a bit because there were dialogues written, but both me, Alia and Jasmeet, we actually sat down on the floor and we like, how do we make this more organic? And what came out was series of dialogues that an exchange which when I finished it, I remember it said that ki मैंने तुमको आज़ादी दी, नहीं तुमको बुरका पहनने के लिए नहीं बोलता हूँ, मैं इतना प्रोग्रेसिव हूँ और ये है, उसके बाद भी तुम ये सब कामा सुतरा कर रही हो, ये सब चल रहा है. बट द एक्सचेंज बिकेम सो रियल दैट मी एंड आलिया कम्प्लीटली लॉस्ट आवरसेल्व्स इन दैट मोमेंट. एंड व्हेन दैट कट हैपेंड वी जस्ट फिगर्ड दैट वी अचीव द मोमेंट विच इज रेयर विच हैपेंस वेरी फ्यू टाइम्स यू नो इन अ फिल्म एंड यू आर लकी इफ यू कैन टैप ऑन टू इट समटाइम्स. So I knew that we had a moment. I remember when we had a moment in Gully Boy. So those moments are very precious for me as an actor.
So,
Nair? Oh, wow. We're doing opposite ends. For me, it was the climax of Ye Kali Kali Aankhein. Because there's a scene where my character Vikrant is teaching himself through the episodes of how to fake cry. And in the end, he's got to go and confess to a very powerful politician that he's killed his daughter. But the brief from the director is you're teaching yourself how to fake cry, but you have to do it in such a way that you haven't completely learned. So fake cry, but do it badly. Say something, but don't actually mean it.
Right.
And this is the climax of an 8-episode series, but we're shooting it on day 4 of the show.
Oh my God.
Yeah. And I've got Saurabh Shukla and Vijinder Kala, who are like veteran stage actors over there. And for me, powerful performances are where there are no words.
Yeah.
And there were no words in this. You just walk into a room thinking something, saying something else, and fake crying. And it was just a mix of everything. And yeah, so that I stepped out off set saying, this is why I do what I do.
Oh, lovely. Shefali?
So there are a lot of scenes from Delhi Crime. But now, I'm glad you came to me a little later because I was thinking of what scene.
And which season?
Which season?
or Darlings, if you like, whatever.
Yeah,
no, Darlings. Delhi Crime.
Oh, whichever film.
I'm sorry. In DC2, there's a sequence where you see Vartika getting ready in front of the mirror.
Mm.
And I've waited very long in my career to actually figure why. I mean, you keep questioning yourself when you're only waiting. Why am I even doing this? Mm-hmm. But when I stepped into her shoes again and I see that scene and it's just like, that's why I'm doing this.
Right.
You know, so I mean, there's a lot of pride.
Sure.
And finally, after years, I mean, what I love doing is out there and it's getting equal reciprocation from people. So yeah, that is.
How lovely. Jyoti?
I think for me also, it's difficult to pick one scene because I loved being Kala right from the beginning till the end of the film. But if I still have to pick one scene, it has to be that delirium sequence where she sees her whole life play out in front of her. And, you know, Anvita's brief to me was that I don't want her to be there. I mean, you're there, but I want you to have an out-of-body experience. And I was like, how am I going to do that? How does that happen? And then we had Ashley Lobo, sir, who's a very famous acting coach, and we had workshops with him. And that guy is like pure magic. Like he says something to you and you actually have that kind of an experience. So, you know, I mean, obviously when you shoot, you're shooting for 16, 17 hours. You can't feel like that for those many hours. But there were times where I was not aware of my body, where I was like, I don't know where I am. I don't know what this is. I'm just moving with people. And that just felt so special. And yeah, that particular scene.
That's a terrific scene, actually. Karthik?
मेरा फेवरेट सीन तो एडिट ही हो गया था
वो हमेशा होता है
तो भूल भुलैया में ऐसा हुआ था
उसके बारे में लोग बात कैसे समझाओ
बात ही नहीं होती तो बट मैं सेकंड टू दैट आई थिंक द क्लाइमैक्स ऑफ भूल भुलैया उसमें देयर वर अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स आई हैड टू I don't know, वो मेक बिलीव कराना था कि मंजुलिका की आत्मा इस बंदे के रूह बाबा के अंदर आ गई है एंड द बंगाली एक्सेंट एंड द एंटायर डायलॉग्स उस टाइम जब हमने परफॉर्म सबने किया था या उसको शूट किया था सो इट वॉज मोस्टली इन बंगाली सो फॉर मी टू डू दैट वॉज अगेन मैं हिंदी में तो वो कर सकता हूँ इम्प्रोवाइजेशन और ये सब वो बंगाली में फिर यू गेट स्टक तो बट देन वेन उसका जब फाइनल रिजल्ट या आउटकम आया and the way it sounded and the way jiski wajah se wo ek portrayal of the superpower jo bhi wo pura hua I was so happy to see the reaction of the audience and everybody just getting so entertained right. and specially not just the adults or you know the kids it's wo har generation ke sab logon ne usko enjoy kiya and I was just fulfilled because main apne aap ko I mean all of us I think we believe that we are entertainers in some way or the you know and I feel that wo moment mere liye bahut entertaining tha because I had to do Amije Tumar also usme bhi performance tha there was dance there was different accent there was of course performing all those things together so for me that was the scene aur jo edit hua wo mere ek dad ke sath scene tha jo emotional scene tha mere dad ka pura portion hi cut ho gaya actually
bechara dad
I didn't have any dad
credit mein hai unka naam
nahi apne aap wo kya comedy film the chalo baad mein baat kare
to all of you is acting fun or is it hard work
I think it's a mix of both.
Yeah.
Yeah. At times, I mean, when you do it well, then you start having fun with it. But jab tak crack nahi hota na, till then it feels very difficult. Till then you're like, how do I crack this character? And I feel, and that is something that works for me. I believe in doing a lot of workshops. Without workshops, if I go on set, then I won't be good. That's what I feel about my.
I think self. Acting is fun. But careers are hard work, man.
What?
Yeah, yeah
Shiva.
You hit it on the spot. I mean, Tripti and I were talking earlier, and we were like, "What is hard work?
Careers.
Making careers."
And I think everyone here will agree, acting is amazing. It's like meditative. It's it's why you do what you do. It's everything that goes around it to make sure that happens. That makes it hard work.
I think hard work is fun, right?
Oh, next level.
Yeah.
Raj being Raj.
No, seriously. Like,
mehnat karo.
Says Raj.
No, mehnat karo, of course. Like for me, there are parts which are a lot of fun to do, like Stree or a Bareilly ki Barfi, which I know, or Ludo. You know, it's all about going and really enjoying with your lines and with your co-actor and then improvising. And that's fun. That's a lot of fun to do and to see the reaction as well. But when it's a lot of hard work, you do a film like Shahid or a Trapped, for me, that's more fun. Where, you know, you know that you'll achieve something as an actor which you're looking for there will be some growth after this film after working with this fine filmmaker and on this subject so for me hard work is a lot of fun I feel the more I work hard on a character I feel more satisfied as an actor you know okay at least I gave my everything to this part
right.
and not just took it lightly ke you know yeah ho jayega na
I think if it wasn't fun, why do it?
Yeah.
And why do it for so many years?
Correct.
This is 22 years since I did my first film. Wow. And the hard part is me not getting in the way of it. Because whenever I have felt low, whenever I have stumbled, it's because I've compared myself to others. I have become restless with the weight. I have thought that I should be doing much more. I'm getting much less. These things. Yeah. My mom got diagnosed of cancer 3 years ago, and all that just went out of the window. Yeah. And all I was left with is, what do I love doing? I must do just that. I love spending time with my family. I will never let my work come in the way of spending time with my family. And I will give my 100% to work as well. I'll do what I really love. Who I work with is has to be people I love,
yeah,
even if they are not commercially huge names. Because those 20 years I spent thinking that I have to tick the marks or work with the right people, position myself, maybe I shouldn't do so many indie films. After my mom, all that has changed, Rajiv. So now the hard work is purely in building, representing those women that I'm playing. Like, I feel like I am their lawyer and I have to protect them. Whether they're, you know, good women, bad women, whatever.
Right.
My only job is to protect their lives so that when people watch her, they can see her humanity.
Mm.
Because the world is so hard, you know, life is hard, you know, so that, I think it's now I can say that because I haven't put that pressure on myself to get anywhere, to arrive anywhere, to be on the cover of nothing, that I can now really feel that it is just pure fun.
Right.
You know?
Right. What a lovely way to look at it. Yeah. Anyone else wants to add to this?
I think everybody has gone through something like,
yeah,
this in life. I have gone through it post Leela Majnu, 2 years when there was no work and everybody was like, don't do this, don't do that. So many advices were coming my way and I was like, I am so confused. I don't know what to do next. And you do, you know, at that point in time, you lose a sense of yourself. Yeah. You start comparing yourself to others. You start complaining. But I feel now I've come to a point where I feel like, you know, if I'm not comfortable doing something, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to sell myself. I am just, if I'm getting something and if it's good, if I like it, then only I'll do it. Otherwise, you know, I feel it's so important to have good experience while working. This is something that we love doing. And if you're going on set and not having a good experience, then what's the point?
Sure.
So I think for me now, experience is what matters than anything else.
It's not easy for me. Because every time I go in front of the camera, I'm like, I don't know what to do, where to start from.
Wow.
So it's not easy, but I just love it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm the happiest on set. I love it so much.
I can be a testimonial to that. I work with her. She's beaming with joy every time
that's
she's
true,
on set.
Too.
Excited
that's where
about
she belongs.
Every single day. Yeah. Never a dull moment. It's incredible.
And that makes such a difference.
Yeah, it makes all the difference.
Set. You don't
a happy
want
set
to
is
be with
probably
yeah.
Oh, yeah,
happy
right?
bunch of people on the set is irreplaceable.
Yeah,
and that energy really it reciprocates.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, I think you look like you have a lot of fun. You look like it's fun for you.
I don't know what else to do.
Yeah.
मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि इसके अलावा मेरे लिए ना हॉलीडेज है ना मेरे लिए कुछ और है. मुझे लगता है सेट ही मेरा पूरा यू नो एक जगह है जहाँ पे मैं काम करता हूँ एक जगह है जहाँ पे मैं हॉलीडे करता हूँ एक जगह है सो इट्स आई डोंट नो आई जस्ट हैव फन व्हाइल डूइंग दिस एंड आई जस्ट इन्जॉय लर्निंग एंड थैंकफुली पिछले कुछ टाइम से नाउ आई एम गेटिंग दोज चांसेस टू एक्चुअली कोलैबोरेट विद अ लॉट ऑफ बिग डायरेक्टर्स एंड डायरेक्टर्स हु कैन एक्चुअली वर्क एंड हेल्प मी विद माई क्राफ्ट ऑल्सो सो आई एम जस्ट सो लाइक अ चाइल्ड आई एम जस्ट यू नो लर्निंग एवरी थिंग इट्स अ न्यू डे फॉर मी एवरी डे एंड आई एम जस्ट हैप्पी एंड आई एम जस्ट लकी टू बी वेयर आई एम राइट नाउ एंड आई जस्ट हैव नो रिग्रेट्स एंड यू नो फेलियर्स हो सक्सेस हो इट्स ऑल माई डिसीजन सो आई एम जस्ट happy with the way my life has just carved and I just wanted to continue and maybe flourish even more.
Yeah, that's what. That's what.
Rajiv, because you...
Sorry. No.
Then please, Rajiv.
Because you used the word hard in your question
yeah.
and just to echo what Raj was saying earlier, I think anything that's worth it is never going to be easy.
Sure.
Anything that's easy is not really worth it.
Mm.
I sort of go by that. The joy of watching something that you've done to remember that actually I'd slept only 3 hours the previous night.
Yeah.
It was 48 degrees and we still managed to pull that off. That's a different cake every time.
Yeah. So pushing your boundaries.
Yeah.
Mere liye
acting? Mehnat hai, bahut zyada mehnat hai ya maza hai?
मज़ा ही कह सकते हैं जी क्योंकि मैं एक्टर ऐसे मेरा करियर मैं अपने आप को एक्टर नहीं देखता
जी, आप
ये बहुत बड़े एक्टर बैठे हैं मैं
सबका थैंक यू बहुत बड़े परफॉर्मर हैं
तो थैंक यू आपने मुझे बुलाया सर इस इतने कमाल के एक्टर्स के साथ तो मेरे लिए तो मतलब ये होता है कि यार ये लोग मतलब सच में मेरे को चाहते हैं कि मैं एक्टिंग करूं तो मैं ऐसे करता रहता हूं एंजॉय के लिए बट मेरे लिए ऐसा कुछ ऐसा हार्ड नहीं होता क्योंकि अगर तो आपको किसी चीज का पता हो
जी
तो आप उस चीज पे वर्क करते हो और अगर नहीं पता हो तो फिर आप एंजॉय कर सकते हो तो मैं एंजॉय करता हूं
पर आपके परफॉर्मेंसेस इतने नेचुरल हैं शायद इसलिए इट डजंट फील लाइक हार्ड वर्क
हां जी ठीक
है एंड ही इज सो फुल ऑफ जॉय ही इज सो फुल ऑफ जॉय लाइक
अरे पाजी का इंस्टाग्राम बहुत फनी है
दैट्स ट्रू
वो वीडियोस ये बनाते हैं
इनको पहला प्यार म्यूजिक
हां जी 100% म्यूजिक साउंड म्यूजिक ये तो मतलब आप लोगों के साथ बैठा हूँ
बड़ी पहले इनको बोला था पाजी मेरे को टिकट चाहिए आपका सोल्ड आउट जा रहा है
पता नहीं क्यों मुझे बहुत ऑकवर्ड लग रहा है
यार सच में आप बड़े मैंने आप सबका काम देखा है तो मतलब मैं आपको आपके फेस देखता हूँ तो मुझे ना वो नेटफ्लिक्स पे ऐसी चीजें वो सब दिखने लगती है स्त्री देखी है बुलबुलैया देखी है इनकी किस्सा देखी है
आपकी परफॉर्मेंस
उड़ता पंजाब ये मतलब जब रणबीर सिंह के पीछे से आ रहे हैं मतलब वो सब चीजें मेरे लिए सपना है यहाँ बैठा
But you can sing and act and perform live like that's
thank
my
gift.
God.
Thank you, thank you.
What a gift.
You know, when you get a script, जब आपके पास script आती है, do you ever get scared that I won't be able to deliver?
I make sure I pick
those scripts as often as I can. It's not possible to get those kind of scripts very easily because you sometimes have to fill in those few months that you have.
Right.
And nothing exciting is around, nothing challenging is around. But when you pick that up and those 2 months, 3 months before you start filming is when you're like, main shayad hag dunga. then you are scared. Dar lagta hai, neend nahi aati. आधी रात को उठ के एक थॉट आता है फिर आप लिखना शुरू करते हो कुछ याद आता है किसी की फोटो खींच के रेफरेंस निकालते हो कोई गाना सुन के कुछ उसके बारे में सोचते हो वो जो पागलपन होता है मुझे बहुत पसंद है तो आई ऑल्सो बिकॉज आई हैव टेकन सम चांसेस एंड रिस्क एंड दे टर्न आउट टू बी सो सैटिस्फाइंग एज एन एक्सपीरियंस आई एम मोर इंक्लाइंड टूवर्ड्स मेकिंग मोर नाउ
जितनी भी स्क्रिप्ट्स मैंने भी आज तक पढ़ी है फर्स्ट टाइम व्हेन आई रीड इट आई फील लाइक अरे नहीं हो पाएगा दैट्स एग्जैक्टली व्हाट आई फेल्ट व्हेन आई रेड कला इट्स सच अ कॉम्प्लेक्स कैरेक्टर अनविता स्ट्रेंजली वो शोइंग अ लॉट ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस एंड आई वाज लाइक मुझे नहीं पता है कैसे होना है एंड देन फिर हम जब बैठे स्क्रिप्ट पे 2 महीने तक वी वर जस्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट इट टॉकिंग अबाउट द वर्ल्ड टॉकिंग अबाउट हर एंड देन Even then, I didn't have the confidence. Even then, I was like, "Baatein toh kar li hai, but set pe pata nahi hoga ki nahi hoga." It's only when I get into costume, when you get on set, is when you start feeling a little confident and start feeling, "Yeah, okay, theek hai, now it's going somewhere." Mm. But every character I feel makes you a little scared.
It's like a relationship, na? It's like when you start a relationship.
Yeah, initially it's
initially interested in the guy, and you're like. Let's see what he's about.
That's a good analogy.
Right? It's like slowly you fall in love. There's fear. What if this breaks your heart? and what if it, you don't... So that excitement, it's, I think that agony and ecstasy of love that you feel when you're in love, there's those highs. And if it's really a challenging script and the filmmaker is really knows their material, I often find that writer-directors have a different relationship with their material and the way they can push an actor is and then that love affair kind of starts and that has a bit of both na
Kartik no
dar
aaj ha real
lagta hai har bar lagta hai I think mujhe to har bahut bar lagta hai ki ye kuch gadbad na ho jaye yahan pe ऊपर से मैं कई बार ये अभी आई डोंट नो हाउ टू पुट इट करेक्टली बट कई बार ये एस्पेक्ट भी देखता हूँ कि कंटेंट और कमर्शियल सिनेमा का कितना मिक्स हो रहा है ये फिल्मों में ताकि अभी हम नेटफ्लिक्स पे बैठे हैं तो मैं थिएटर्स की बात कर सकता हूँ
बिल्कुल
कर सकता हूँ
सिंगल स्क्रीन की बात
तो वो भी देखना इम्पोर्टेंट हो जाता है फॉर एग्जाम्पल धमाका में मुझे ये लगा था क्योंकि हमारे पास उस टाइम और राम माधवानी सर जिस तरीके के वो डायरेक्टर हैं उनका सब प्लानिंग इतना स्ट्रॉन्ग रहता है तो मुझे ऐसा लग रहा था कि मैं कुछ गड़बड़ ना कर दूँ बिकॉज मुझे लग रहा था मैं ही उसमें एक वीक लिंक हूँ बाकी सब मतलब सब लेजेंडरी लोग हैं एंड वी शॉट दैट फिल्म इन लाइक 9 days तो कंप्लीट फिल्म 9 days में एक जगह पे वो 9 days में
9 days
360 डिग्री कैमरा में ऐसे जैसे अभी इंटरव्यू कर रहे हैं वैसे ही वो सेटअप में फिल्म हुई थी
आई टॉक अबाउट आपके पोर्शन या पूरी फिल्म?
पूरी फिल्म, पूरी फिल्म एग्जैक्ट 9 days में खत्म हुई थी.
दे क्रिएटेड अ बबल, नो?
दे क्रिएटेड अ बबल दैट वाज वन ऑफ द फ्यू फिल्म्स जो उस टाइम आइसोलेशन के टाइम पे जब सब लोग हमें घर पे थे हम लोग, तो तब वो प्लान की गई थी. और वो ऐसे प्लान की थी कि यू नो आई पर्सनली डिडंट नो कि व्हाट्स द वे फॉरवर्ड, एंड आई डोंट थिंक सो किसी को भी पता था उस टाइम. वी वर जस्ट फिगरिंग आउट स्टफ, मे बी ऑन सोशल मीडिया, मे बी कि अच्छा OTT films भी हम Netflix films भी कैसे करें, या फिर हम थिएटर्स में भी कैसे करें काम. सो दिस वॉज द आइडिया जिसमें एक ये था कि आइसोलेशन में एक फिल्म करते हैं. एंड वही होटल को पूरा कॉर्डन ऑफ करके वहाँ पे जितने लोग रहे थे, तो वो 10 दिन के लिए, 16 दिन के लिए हम वहाँ पे थे. उन 9 दिनों में वो शूट की गई. एंड और मतलब 10-10, 12-12 पेज एक बार में चलता था. एंड इट वॉज जस्ट, तो वो अलग तरीके का एक फिल्मिंग था जिसमें मैं बहुत डरा हुआ था उस टाइम कि ये कैसे होगा, क्योंकि मोनोलॉग्स मैंने किए हैं मतलब वो सब, बट ये तो मतलब चले ही जा रहा है, रोज के मोनोलॉग्स हैं, एक दिन का नहीं है. तो वो डिफिकल्ट था. बट ऐसी फिल्म्स में बहुत ऐसा डर लगता है. भूल भुलैया में भी फॉर एग्जांपल ऐसा डर था कि अच्छा कमर्शियल सक्सेस उसकी कितनी बड़ी.
यू आर प्लेइंग एट अ डिफरेंट पिच ना इन अ फिल्म लाइक भूल भुलैया.
पिच ही पूरी अलग थी. मैंने उस तरीके की कॉमेडी है, उस तरीके की सोनू टीटू की जोन बहुत अलग है फ्रॉम अ भूल भुलैया, उसका पिच बहुत अलग है. सो बट आई वॉज रियली हैप्पी एंड आई वॉज रियली ब्लेस्ड टू हैव अ डायरेक्टर लाइक अनीस बाजमी सर एंड द एंटायर टीम अगेन विद द राइटर्स, द काइंड ऑफ राइटिंग दे डिड विच वॉज फॉर द फैमिलीज. एंड सो या, तो वो बैलेंस हो जाता है. आई थिंक इट्स ऑलवेज लाइक हाउ तिलोत्तमा इन्होंने बोला कि वो रिलेशनशिप एक होता है राइटर्स और डायरेक्टर्स का, उनके साथ जो तालमेल बैठता है, आई थिंक दैट्स व्हाट टेक्स यू फॉरवर्ड.
राज,
वेल या, आई थिंक यू गेट स्केयर्ड एवरी टाइम
इवन
यू रीड अ स्क्रिप्ट. या या, ऑफ कोर्स आई एम द मोस्ट नर्वस अ नाइट बिफोर वी स्टार्ट फिल्म. के कल सुबह शूट है, एंड लाइक स्पेशली इफ इट्स अ, you know, it's one of those films. I get very nervous, and it takes, I think as an actor, it takes you 2-3 days to, for me, it takes me around 2-3 days to figure out, okay, this is the voice of my character, this is who he is, because I'm like, of course you do your prep and everything, but by the time you do it practically, you don't really figure out. As they say, acting is to do.
Yeah,
you have to do it to figure out things. But I get pretty nervous every time, but it's nice. I love, I think the more scared you are, I think it's good. You'll push yourself.
It's a good energy.
Yeah, it's a good energy.
Exactly. I think karna bahut zaruri hai. Otherwise, how will you improve? Yeah. You keep on doing the same thing, then there's no scope of improvement only.
Excitement bhi usi baat ka hai.
Yeah, I think fear is the indicator that something's going right.
Yeah.
Because if not, then you're complacent.
Yeah, but the right kind of fear. Not like, oh my God, this actor's crazy, I better, like, yeah. You know, माता चढ़ गई वाली acting, थप्पड़ सच का थप्पड़ मार दिया.
No, not that kind of fear. That's toxic fear.
हाँ, not toxic fear.
And because you
that's real fear.
That's real fear.
That doesn't help us.
Real fear, yeah.
Paji, Shefali?
Oh, all the time.
Yeah.
But when I read a script, my first reaction is, either I fall in love with it or I'm sorry, I'm not a part of it. And then it strikes me ki haan to bol diya, ab karenge kaise? You know, so that is every day when I go to set. Every single day.
Wow. Paji?
Nahi, mujhe dar nahi lagta. Haan ji.
Ekdam lagta hai ye kar paunga.
Yehi hai na.
Haan ji, matlab या तो जो मुझे अच्छा लगता है वो करता हूँ, या कोई दोस्त यार जानता होता है कि इसकी फिल्म करनी है तो वो कर देते हैं.
जी,
तो ऐसे कोई तलवार नहीं है कि ये तुम्हें ये करना है, तो फिर डर की तो वहाँ गुंजाइश रहती नहीं.
That's why there's an ease in him.
Yeah, that's
like
true.
New, such an ease.
There's just such a yeah. So how many pages into a script do you kind of know whether this is something for me or not, or this is something I'm going to do or not? How many pages does it take to kind of figure out how you feel about it?
I give it a chance. I give the entire script a chance.
Wow.
Yeah, because, you know, it's not about how many lines you have or how
Correct.
Many scenes you have. You neither the placement of it. I mean, you could probably come in the second half, in the last end of it.
Right.
But if it's a powerful role and it's pertinent to the subject, and so you never really know. Or maybe it's just umeed ke, शायद कभी कुछ आज it might just surprise me. So I don't know how many pages it takes for me to realize whether I want to do it, but I think in the first 10-15 pages itna samajh mein aata, okay, this one's not for me.
Uh-huh.
So you know,
yeah. But you read it to the end, huh?
No, if I realize it's not for me, then I'll say sorry. Matlab, okay. I don't understand it, right. And I won't be able to deliver my best.
Okay.
But yeah.
Vijay?
Pretty much like how chef's process is. But if it is not exciting, then you know it very early on.
Yeah.
तो एक गंदा सा dialogue रहेगा उसमें. कुछ तो एक हाँ कुछ तो एक ऐसे मतलब wannabe tendency कुछ भी पकड़ में आ जाता है वो लिखा हुआ शब्द पकड़ में आ जाता है एकदम से तो वो समझ में आ जाता है कि ये गड़बड़ जा रहा है and then if the premise is interesting then I go ahead if the premise is also not exciting then I'm like बेड़ा गर्क then I but if it is exciting then I'm waiting for it to keep me I'm like subconsciously I'm really like wanting the script to keep pleasing me like keep exciting me because bahut mushkil se aise script aati hai jo aapko leke chalti hai saath mein aap ghuse rehte ho usme you can't keep it aside when that happens it's the best day like I'm beaming for the next 2-3 days thinking about it thoughts coming in my head how to play this how to make it happen ye kaise main le jaungi film sara sab kuch
सबसे खराब जब लगता है जब बहुत अच्छा डायरेक्टर लगता है लेकिन स्क्रिप्ट बहुत खराब है तो वो समझ नहीं आता कि उस सिचुएशन में क्या करो क्योंकि
आपके साथ काम करने पर इस स्क्रिप्ट में
बट हाँ ये कैसे बोलो वो बहुत बार होता है तो बहुत बार मतलब कभी कभी होता है लेकिन या आई मीन जब यू गेट टू नो कई बार ये भी होता है कि जो मेन हुक है या एंड तक आते आते एक ऐसा हुक होता है जो आपको बहुत पसंद है लेकिन एंटायरली जब आप पढ़ रहे हो तब आपको समझ ही
नहीं आता एक्साइटमेंट
नहीं है तो आप वहां पे भी फंसते हो सो माय थिंग इज मैं पूरा ही रीड करता हूँ मैं कभी भी ये ट्राई करता हूँ कि कोई भी अच्छी स्क्रिप्ट बड़ी मुश्किल से जैसे विजय बोल रहा था कि बड़ी मुश्किल से अच्छी स्क्रिप्ट आती है और वो जाने नहीं दे सकते
yeah.
तो वो एक वो रहता है कि यार इसमें सब कुछ पढ़ लिया ना ऐसा गड़बड़ तो नहीं हुआ सो एक वो टेंडेंसी रहती है But you get to know with the language, you get to know with the premise, you get to know with the kind of characters
right.
जो हैं उसमें. So yeah.
जल्दी पता चल रहा है.
जल्दी पता लगने लगता है.
Raj,
I think I give it a go till say 25-30 pages.
Mm.
But there are times when you get to know on the second and third page only that this is not the kind of cinema I want to do or I want to be a part of.
Mm.
This is not my language. So, like saying what Shefali ma'am was saying, 30 pages. If you don't get it, then I don't want to waste my time and tell them. Listen, I'm really not connecting with it at all. Let's just pass it.
Mm-hmm.
And there are scripts which you, as you know, Karthik was saying, they're the makers who you really want to work with, you really look up to, but the script is not right up there.
Mm-hmm.
Then that's a very tricky situation. Now, how to handle that?
Yeah, how do they take
either
it?
Either you. What happens is that they think that they will handle it.
They will handle it. Either you trust yeah. them and tell them
Vision
very over. Honestly. Ke, listen, it's. There, but it's not right, really up there.
Mm.
But so it's awesome.
Can we do something about it?
Yeah,
I think. But you know, I'll give you an example. Like I read Monica's script, I loved it from the scene one, like the whole robot thing, and I loved it. But when I saw the film, I think that's a maker's vision. What Vasan has done with that film, with that story, it's genius. Yeah. I think the way he packaged the whole thing, the background music, the songs, the crisp editing, those high-speed shots, action, kung fu, I think it's all Vasan.
Yeah.
So sometimes a maker can, or the whole team yeah. can take the script from level A to right up there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyone else? See, Rajiv, I've been waiting for so long. In those 20 years, easily 10 years. You know, I would do one film, wait for 2 years, 3 years.
Mm.
So when a script would come to me, I will read it. Even if I don't like it,
yeah.
I'll finish reading it because मुझे लगता कि आपने प्यार से मुझे दिया है मेरा इतना फर्ज तो बनता कि मैं पढ़ लूँ इसे और इतनी humility होनी चाहिए मुझे लगता है क्योंकि मैंने अपने आप कुछ लिखा नहीं है लिखना इतना आसान नहीं है इसीलिए जब अच्छी स्क्रिप्ट आती है you are not going to let it go you know but I have always read and I've learned so much what how not to write you know what is not interesting that you can have a great premise but if you're not going to get a good dialogue writer you can't underestimate be actors cannot do anything it is not an actor's medium film is not an actor's medium if the writer hasn't written it we can't produce
yeah
it, you know so it's definitely the script is my hero you know And but I always read it. Always read it, and I feel very happy. Even if I have to say no, I'll have bheja to. मतलब इतने प्यार से भेजा तो इसका ये करना चाहिए.
So you were saying something.
Yeah, I was saying that for me, I think at this point,
मुझे उतनी जल्दी समझ नहीं आता है लाइक 30 पेजेस इनटू इट आई डोंट थिंक आई एम एबल टू गेज इट वेदर दिस इज अ गुड स्टोरी वेदर द पार्ट इज गुड फॉर मी आई हैव टू गो थ्रू द होल स्क्रिप्ट आप पूरी पढ़ने के बाद ही आई कैन मेक अ सेंस ऑफ ये कैरेक्टर इज गुड फॉर मी और नॉट गुड फॉर मी और वेदर इट्स चैलेंजिंग इनफ फॉर मी और जो कि ये लोग बात कर रहे थे ये मेरे साथ भी हुआ है दो तीन बार बड़े बड़े लोगों को मना करना पड़ा है एंड देयर इज ऑलवेज दैट फियर यू नो बिकॉज आई एम न्यू ऑल्सो सो एट टाइम्स पीपल टेक इट एज मी बींग रूड और मी बींग कि यार अभी तो नहीं आई है बहुत एटीट्यूड है इसमें क्या अभी हमें मना कर रही है बट आई थिंक इट्स सो इम्पॉर्टेंट टू से नो टू थिंग्स यू डोंट लाइक बिकॉज यू नो इट्स एक फिल्म में सिर्फ एक्टर्स नहीं होते हैं देयर आर सो मेनी पीपल इन्वॉल्व्ड इन अ प्रोजेक्ट देयर आर मोर देन 300 टू 500 पीपल हु मेक अ फिल्म एंड इफ यू बीइंग एन एक्टर इफ यू आर नॉट हैप्पी विद व्हाट यू आर डूइंग एंड इफ यू गो देयर विद यू नो हाफ हार्टेडली यू आर नॉट एंजॉयिंग इट देन द होल फिल्म सफर्स सो इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट टू टेक दोज डिसीजंस देन एंड देयर रादर देन मेकिंग एवरीबॉडी एल्स सफर
25 पेजेस द फर्स्ट एक्ट इज इनफ टू नो इफ इट्स नॉट going well but that doesn't mean that you're not going to read the full script par wo kahin na kahin back of the mind pata hota hai ki yaar ye us tarah nahi ja raha jo maine socha tha but by the end of it if you feel that there's even something there then like Rajan Karthik was saying it always makes sense to meet the people to see ki iska kya kar sakte ho aap and I have to be honest with ye kali kali aankhe that happened on paper that part was so out there in terms of dramatic and pulpy and the way it was written that I felt that anything I did with this is going to make it look too loud so how are you going to treat it and then when they run you through what the edit the grade the music and all of that's going to be it sort of convinces you to take that leap of faith
so
bhai padhna mere liye thoda tough hai isliye main
narration mangta
hu ha sun leta hu ya doston ko de deta hu pad isko sun to kai bar sahi salah mil jati hai kai bar aise bhi ho jata hai to chalo bhai sara kuch hi fun hai
जी
तो मैं सुनने में ज्यादा मेरे को अच्छा लगता है या फीलिंग कभी आया भाई ठीक लग रहा है चलो चक दो
इंस्टिंक्ट पर
हां जी
एंड राजीव आल्सो व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड आउट आई गॉट सच स्मॉलर पार्ट्स राइट एंड दे वुड जस्ट सेंड यू द साइड्स ऑफ द पार्ट द कैरेक्टर आई वाज लाइक फिल्म क्या है वो दो ना मेरा पार्ट छोटा है पर फिल्म अच्छा होना चाहिए ना व्हाई शुड आई बी अ स्मॉल पार्ट ऑफ समथिंग व्हिच इज एवरेज
या
आई एम हैप्पी टू बी अ स्मॉल पार्ट ऑफ समथिंग दैट्स ब्यूटीफुल
राइट
So for me, reading the whole thing has been very important. Whether it's like, even for Hindi medium, it was a cameo. But I want to know what is the world of the film.
Yeah. Right, in context of...
In context.
Sure.
But there are times when I really trusted the makers. Like when Motwani's sir told me about Trapped.
Yeah.
He just told me in one line, this is a guy who's trapped in an apartment, no water, no food, no electricity. That's the film. Yeah. And I'm a big Motwani fan. Yeah. So I said, you know, we're doing it. Because as an actor, there's so much, you know, that there's so much that you can do. And I'm a big fan of survival dramas.
Mm-hmm.
Same with Shahid. When I met Hansa sir, he's like, there's this guy, this happened. That's the film. It's like, I'm doing it.
Right.
Because sometimes you feel that connect with the maker that, you know, I'd really trust him blindly.
Right.
Like whatever he'll do, I would love to be a part of him. And the story is great. And rest, I think he'll figure out.
Yeah.
He or she will figure out. Yeah.
Paid off in both those instances.
Luckily, yeah.
Vijay, your character in Darlings, the alcoholic, abusive husband, Hamza, he's a really unlikable guy. And yet, it's such a mercurial performance that it's hard to take your eyes off the screen when he's up there. Do you ever worry that the audience might not like you when you're playing a nasty character?
The good thing is, at least in the echo chamber I am in, people around me and people who are probably on social media writing comments or sometimes if I see a comment on YouTube or whatever, I can tell that these people can differentiate between the actor and the character.
Right.
Thankfully, we're no longer in the 80s. So I won't be Ranjit for the rest of my life.
Correct.
But having said that, I did meet a couple of friends and one of my friends, she said her mom went to some kitty party and my name was being discussed on this big table was elderly women playing cards.
Uh-huh.
That guy is so bad. He's such a terrible guy. And this my friend's mom is trying to defend me. Like, he's actually a good boy. My daughter works with him. He's like, no, he looks like he's that guy. So it's a perception that can probably live outside of my echo chamber. I have no reason to believe that people will not hate me outside of my work. But you know, I get to play these juicy parts and I'm not complaining.
Have any of you played a character that you don't like?
Omar Sheikh in Omerta.
Yeah.
I played a few of them.
Yeah.
I mean, Mardani.
Vijay in Queen.
Sure.
Yeah, Mardani.
Yeah.
Queen's, my cat in Queen, Vijay. LSD, Ragini MMS, so many, yeah.
But I think when you're in it, you can't afford to not like what you're playing. You have to.
Oh, sorry, judgment. When you say yes, you drop all those judgments and you get into prep and
Yeah.
Do it. Yeah.
And have fun with it.
So are you justifying his personality, his actions to be able to play him convincingly to yourself at least?
Yeah,
so,
but
in my mind, I'm justifying whatever Omar Sheikh is doing. I believe in what he believes in. I believe in his ideology.
Mm. For sure. But, same with.
But only in that process.
Yeah.
Not before and after that.
Right.
I'm not able to do this, but what I'm able to do is I try to hold on to something that I resonate with.
Mm.
Like with Hamza, I found out that he is an alcoholic, he's an abusive person, he's not nice to anybody, everybody dislikes him and all these things, but he's very loyal to his wife.
Right.
He just comes back to his wife, he wants to eat the khana that she cooks. He wants to give her a good time, he wants to gift her. So these are some traits that you like in the character that, because script mein to likha hai ki ye karega.
Correct.
Aise harkate. Mm. But you try to find traits that resonate with you and work with them. In She, I play a character called Sasya, which is a very diabolical, very like crass, extremely obscene personality. It took me a long time to kind of break the inhibitions. Mm. It's just so embarrassing to be this person in front of 50 people every day.
Yeah.
It was deeply embarrassing to utter those
words.
It's
a really creepy line.
And look at my co-actor in a certain way. And I had to do all of it because I felt like that's the character.
Yeah.
That's how it will come alive and that's how it will translate.
Mm.
But it was deeply embarrassing. And but part of my actor's job is to kind of break all the inhibitions and surrender to the part and do whatever it takes, you know, for you to at least psych yourself up in between action and cut, deliver. Uske baad mein tum apna takke ke piche sar karke dekh lo baad mein jab aayega release pe.
Right. You know, Shefali, one of the most charming scenes in Shawl Darlings is the one where Zulfi makes that confession that his crush on Khala.
Mujhe to Khala cute lagti hai.
And of course that leads, that's such a beautiful
moment. Sabko Khala cute lagti hai.
And then leads to that unexpected moment where she grabs him and kisses him. It's just such a lovely scene. And I also want to say it's such an important scene actually, because so rarely have Hindi films allowed a middle-aged woman, let alone a widow, even be seen as someone who deserves a shot at romance. So what was your reaction when you read that in the script? Your first reaction when you read that?
It was completely unexpected.
Mm.
Yeah. I didn't expect it at all. So when I read it, I was like, huh? And I think it's one of the, like you said, it is easily one of the most beautiful moments in the film.
Yeah.
It's like there are people who ask me that there should be a complete spin-off on
their,
Ala
on
and
their,
Zulfi.
Correct.
Yeah. But it came out of nowhere. And that has, I mean, the credit has to go to Jasmeet and the writers.
Yeah. Tripti, in Kala, you play a playback singer in the 30s and 40s whose life spirals even as her star sort of rises. The only thing she's really seeking is that validation from her mother. It's such a brilliant, heartbreaking, fragile performance, so full of pain. Tripti, how did you prepare to get into the head of that woman? There's a lot of complex things going on in that head.
Yeah. So for this particular thing, I think Anvita and me just spoke about her for 2 months. We were just talking about what kind of person she is, and very little things like where does she sleep, where does she, what does she eat, what kind of food does she like.
Correct.
What is her room like? What is her, what are her bed sheets like? So, you know, when you discuss these things about a character, the, you know, regular things, then I think that's when you get to know the character as well as you know yourself.
Right.
And this is something I think we did for Bulbul also.
Mm.
She, on the first day of workshop, asked me, what's your first memory as Tripti?
Mm.
And I remember talking to her about an incident that happened when I was 5 years old. So she's like, okay, where do you see yourself as Kala when you're 5 years old?
Right.
Let's talk about that. And from 5 to 10, then 10 to 15, then 15 to whatever age is there in the film, we built her experiences. We built her whole life around Kala. And that, when you do that, It's yeah. it's like you know the person in and out. It's like you know what she likes, what she's thinking, mm-hmm. what's her relationship like with her mother, what does she think of her mother actually. You know, right. on screen it's different, but
correct.
What is actually going on in her mind. So we were discussing her thoughts. And in Anvita's film, there are hardly any lines for
That's
us.
True.
So there was, you know, very little scope for me to, you know, actually... Hota hai na, through dialogues, you
Correct.
Kind
you
of sometimes
yeah, yeah, yeah.
understand
yeah, yeah. There was not,
and explain
there was not a lot
what
of,
you're
yeah,
going
yeah.
through. But here, there were no dialogues.
Mm.
And, you know, on this, it was so funny because one day I told her, let's do a reading because I think I know what kind of person she is, but I don't know whether... Mujhe apni dialogue delivery dekhni hai. That's
Correct.
What I told her. And she's like... Dialogue delivery dekhne, achha, let's read it. And my only dialogues in the film were, sorry, mama. Okay, mama. Thank you, mama. She's like, now read the blank page. So the blank page was full of dialogues. And she's like, this is what I want you to say, but only through your eyes. This is what should be going on in your head when you're there on the, when you're performing. Not what's written here, because you hardly have anything.
I would like, yeah.
So that was very interesting to explore, very difficult as well. But yeah, that's how we went for it.
Karthik, you were very funny as Roo Baba in Bhool Bhulaiya 2. You delivered one of the biggest box office hits of the year. It's a blockbuster. It's also one of the films that's been credited with sort of reviving the box office, the industry, in a year that was a bad year for the business. It's made you one of the most bankable stars in the country. Does that come... at a price, Karthik? Isn't there too much pressure to repeat that success? Does it limit the kind of films and roles that you can do going forward? Because now, one only expects, the industry sort of expects that he needs to churn out the blockbusters.
I think, mere liye wo expectation aisa difficult nahi hai ki sochna ki apne upar pressure dalna ki achha agla box office bhi utne level pe aana chahiye. I think, what success of Bhool Bhulaiya did to me was that it gave me, you know, more and more opportunities. Mm-hmm. I think uski wajah se mere paas aur zyada makers aa rahe hain, scripts aa rahi hain. So and that's what happens. I think you give a successful film, aapke paas aur zyada aise scripts aati hain, aur zyada makers aap pe believe bhi karte hain.
Correct.
So that happened with the success of Bhool Bhulaiya 2. I think when we were actually promoting the film and when we had decided to come in theaters at that time, that was really a bad time.
Correct.
And nobody was actually, we were thinking that theaters mein koi ja hi nahi raha hai yahan pe. So wo bahut ajeeb sa time tha aur khud ja ke promote karna aur logo ko aisa lag raha tha ki please theaters aa jao film dekhne aa jao, aap bhul gaye ho film dekhna ki theaters mein bhi dekhte. So it felt like that sometimes, and but wo ek myth bhi hota hai jo create ho jata hai kai bar, films nahi chal rahi hain to unki wajah se ye lagta hai ki kuch bhi nahi chalega. I'm glad that Bhool Bhulaiya did what it did, and to all of us, everyone from the cast and the entire crew and entire team, and I'm just I think my next film uske baad jo aa rahi hai wo Freddy aayi hai.
Yeah.
Wo puri tarah se diametrically opposite hai, pura character hi alag hai.
But that was signed before Karthik. Will you sign that kind of film?
But then there's a Shehzada also, yeah.
Right.
Which is a commercial masala film. But I think ye jo opportunities hai ya ye jo decisions hai, ye soch samajh ke hi liye maine ki not planned the release, I haven't planned that.
Right.
But it's happening on its own, and I think it's falling into place on its own, which is beautiful for me. Because ek taraf ye Roo Baba ka character aa raha hai, to dusri taraf ye this was another character jo aapka pichla sawal tha, Freddy, jisse main real mein connect nahi karta hu.
Right.
Wo ek waisa character hai, but I had to again give those thoughts jahan pe Vijay bhi bol raha tha, nahi mujhe usko अपने दिमाग में एटलीस्ट प्रूव करना है कि वो जो कर रहा है वो सही कर रहा है. ही इज बीन रॉन्ग बाय द सोसाइटी, सो दैट्स व्हाई ही इज गोइंग टू दैट एक्सटेंट एंड व्हाट
टू जस्टिफाई हिम टू
योरसेल्फ जस्टिफाई हिम. सो आई डिडंट कनेक्ट टू हिम एज अ कैरेक्टर कि मैं उस लेवल तक जाऊं कभी लाइफ में. सो वो एक चीज है, बट या आई मीन इट्स नॉट प्रेशर नहीं है. आई थिंक यही सारी चीजें हैं जो हमें यू नो इट टेक्स अस टू अनदर लेवल, एंड आई लव इट. आई एम जस्ट वेटिंग फॉर माई नेक्स्ट रिलीज नाउ विच इज गोना बी शहजादा, एंड And I'm really looking forward to the next one after that, which is Kabir Khan's first film. So, yeah. So it's all, yeah. Itne achhe makers hain, mujhe pressure nahi lena hai.
Shahzada trailer look pretty blockbuster.
Thank you, yeah, thank you.
Raj, your performance in Badhai Do as Shardul, this closeted cop who marries a lesbian, was one of the best performances this year, in my opinion. I think it's just, you know, also I think that in today's times, to say it was a dignified representation, it was, I think we should be able to take those things for granted. It was so authentic. Those are things really now we shouldn't have to hammer and say it was dignified, it was respectful. In 2022, we should expect to take that for granted. You know, that scene where he's drunk in the hotel room and he reveals his frustrations to Bhumi's character, saying, you've heard of, Raj, you should say it, I'm going to ruin it.
Robocop, I'm homocop.
You know, it's one of the most incredible scenes this year. The writing, of course, has to be spot on. But Raj, what is the trick to doing a really poignant scene like that? It's actually a sad scene.
It is a sad scene.
And bringing this moment of sort of humor with such authenticity. I mean, can you talk about how you shot that scene maybe?
I was drunk. So you got actually drunk?
Oh, real?
Yeah. Oh. I don't drink in real life, but when I have to do a scene where I'm drunk, so I tend to drink.
But you don't forget your lines.
No. I tend to improvise a lot.
It's incredible. I think City Lights mein bhi tune kiya tha. Jo scene, mere khayal se, is probably it looked like he's drunk in this scene.
Right. Yeah.
I didn't know about it, but I know.
The first thing I did was I got drunk, and of course I knew the character by then. We luckily shot that scene pretty much in the later schedule in Goa, in one of the hotels in Goa. And for me, the way I saw that scene was exactly how you said. You know, this is the star of his life. This is something which he has never told anyone. Okay, you know, mujhe Miss India banna tha, mere papa the, wo shaheed ho gaye, to mujhe naukri mein laga diya. He hasn't shared this to anyone, and he found a friend who he is married to. And of course, she is also not really interested, but she's sitting there because he's asked her to. But for me, this was his pain. He just wanted to blur it out in front of someone. He couldn't do this with anyone. So I just did that. I really didn't really think too much about it, that, you know, how I'm going to, and I don't do that, how am I going to perform it? Because once you understand the psyche of a character and you know where he is at this point of his life, it just happens.
Yeah.
Like none of us prepared how we're going to speak because who we are, that's who we are. That's how we're going to react. So I think we just went for it. But for me, the reason scene works is, again, Harsh is genius. The moment he falls on the ground, and the camera track backs, and you see how this guy, he's so alone in his life, and he's so drunk. He just wanted to talk to someone. I think that made the scene for me. This, of course, dialogues were, it was brilliant writing, and I did what I had to do. But I think it's again Harsh and his genius, the way it tracks back and the music starts. And that's where I feel like, one second, was I supposed to laugh in this scene? No, it was supposed to touch me, and it did towards the end.
It hits that note beautifully, actually. पाजी आपकी फिल्म जोगी कहानी है एक शख्स की जोगी जो तय कर लेता है कि मैं अपने परिवार और अपने नेबर्स को बचाऊंगा उनको रेस्क्यू करूंगा सेव करूंगा उन दिनों में जो जब एंटी सिख राइट्स दंगे चल रहे थे 1980
जेनोसाइड ये मतलब ये राइट्स और ये
जी जी
ये काफी लिखा गया है
करेक्ट
और
करेक्ट.
इसके बारे में ऐसा बोला गया है
जी.
तो हर एक के दिमाग में ये वैसे ही आ जाता है
जी.
राइट्स जब दो ग्रुप झगड़ते हैं आपस में तो राइट्स हो जाते हैं लेकिन अगर आप किसी को निहत्थे किसी पे आप टारगेट करते हो जेनोसाइड हो जाता है
करेक्ट.
तो मेरे लिए ये फिल्म करना ये बात सॉरी आपका क्वेश्चन
नहीं आप बिल्कुल जो एक्चुअली आपने मेरा मैं क्या पूछने वाला था एक तो बहुत ही स्ट्रॉन्ग और हार्टफेल्ट परफॉर्मेंस है पर आपने कहा है कि आप खुद 1984 में पैदा हुए थे
जी,
आप 90 तो आपके लिए ऑब्वियसली ये एक बहुत और आप एज यू वर ग्रोइंग अप आपने जाहिर है आपने अपने फैमिली वालों से अपने दोस्तों से सुने किससे उन दिनों के क्या ये फिल्म करके ये रोल करके और आपने पहले भी एक पंजाबी फिल्म की है 1984 ऑन अ सिमिलर थीम
जो पंजाब बेस्ड थी
ये स्टोरी दिल्ली में होती है तो आपने पर ये इस इशू पर इस इन इंसिडेंट्स पर जब आप फिल्म करते क्या वो जो स्कार्स हैं वो थोड़े हील होते हैं वो एड्रेस होते हैं जब आप उस स्टोरी को एड्रेस करते हो या जब आप वो रोल प्ले कर रहे हो
सिनेमा मुझे लगता है कि उस चीज को वैसे तो हील नहीं कर सकता लेकिन चाहे वो 1% वो बात कर रहा है तो लेकिन उस चीज़ पे बात हो रही है. लुधियाना में एक ऐसी अभी भी कॉलोनी है जहाँ पे जो सब दिल्ली से जो बच बचा के पहुँचे वो हमारे घर के पास ही है. तो मैं फिल्म रिलीज के बाद नहीं जा पाया लेकिन उस कॉलोनी में से सब लोग इकट्ठे होकर मेरे घर पे आए सिर्फ थैंक्स करने के लिए कि ये बात हो रही है. उस चीज़ का इंसाफ तो नहीं मिला है और वो चीज़ भर भी नहीं सकती है. और सिनेमा कुछ एक हद तक बात कर सकता है. मेरे लिए था कि चाहे 1% वो चीज़ बात हो रही है लेकिन जिन लोगों के साथ वो बीती है बहुत सारे मेरे फ्रेंड्स हैं जो जानने वाले हैं तो उनके दिलों में अंदर अभी भी पड़ा है और अभी भी ये दिमाग में है. मेरे साथ है अभी भी एक शख्स. उनके फादर ने ये बोला था कि यार अब हम ना पक्का घर बनाएंगे नहीं कि पता नहीं है कब यहाँ से जाना पड़ेगा कि अब पक्की छत नहीं करेंगे यार हम. तो जिस शख्स को ये लग रहा है कि यार मैं सेफ ही नहीं हूँ, मैं कभी भी मुझे यहाँ से उठा के कहीं भी फेंक दिया जाएगा या मुझे अपनी जान बचाने के लिए भागना पड़ेगा, तो उस चीज को ऐसे आप सिनेमा से हील तो नहीं कर सकते लेकिन आप बात जरूर कर सकते क्योंकि इंसाफ तो नहीं मिला है सर.
एटलीस्ट उनकी वॉइस बन सकते हो आप.
हाँ जी, ये कह सकते हैं.
You know, what to all of you, what makes you uncomfortable as an actor? Are there any lines that you just won't cross?
Round tables.
Thank you very much.
I wish I could say that nothing's make me uncomfortable, but I think, like, I would say maybe like dancing. आप भी आ जाओ डांस करने का, लाइक नहीं यार प्रैक्टिस चाहिए. और स्टेज पे कोई बोलता है कि कैन यू जस्ट शो अस समथिंग, सो दैट मेक्स मी अ बिट अनकंफर्टेबल. बट एज एन एक्टर आई फील लाइक लेट नाइट शूट्स मेक मी वेरी अनकंफर्टेबल. इफ इट गोज बियॉन्ड 12-13 आवर्स देन आई एम वेरी टायर्ड एंड आई कांट बी माय बेस्ट सेल्फ. द वर्ड OTT मेक्स मी वेरी अनकंफर्टेबल. I don't like the term. Because for actors, it was
over
a term
the
that... Yeah, yeah, it was a term which was over the top and now we just like keeps hearing it everywhere. I'm like, yeah, I'm subtle acting, yeah. Karta yaar. OTT.
Correct.
How
OTT mein kaise pahunche?
True.
I feel like, yeah.
Those are a few things.
That was my mini rant.
मैं बहुत सोचा जी जो
मेरा जोर लग गया
सोच ही रहे
पर सारा समझ नहीं आ रहा
सवाल अनकंफर्टेबल हो गया
कुछ कुछ ऐसे कोई सच एन इजी पर्सन
जोर लाया मैं जी बड़ा जोर लाया कुछ बोल दूंगा गल पर नहीं आया नहीं कोई दूंगा
हाउ लवली ओ
लाइंस या लाइक व्हेन आई हैव टू से अ लॉट ऑफ लाइंस I'm finished. I'm devastated. Yeah, because I'm terrible at memorizing. Because I feel it.
Right.
So if it is an emotional sequence, I understand it emotionally and the lines will fall into place.
Yeah.
But if it is technical information, I'm finished. And I just feel that, I mean... Why say it when you can show it?
Right.
I've seen Mr. Bachchan deal with it so nicely.
Because he has a photographic memory.
Yeah, he's incredible. He'll spend 2 hours just rehearsing before.
He's incredible. Period. Finished. That's.
And every information is there, correct, yeah. Given out.
Anyone else?
I think night shoots. मुझे बहुत uncomfortable होता है night shoots करना. अगेन वही
ये इजी था पाजी यार ये इजी था ये
मैंने 4-5 दे दिए
वाओ ये हो
गया नया ढूंढ सोचा
सबके लिए
मुझे लगता है
I've done a lot of it. It's just like, I've come around. Like, I'm
more comfortable.
No, because very technical.
Yeah. It is. As soon as you realize technical, you are comfortable.
Yeah.
Because you're not supposed to like feel everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you shot with an intimacy coordinator?
Yeah, I have.
An intimacy coordinator.
Is,
like,
that's
right.
पता नहीं मैं बोलना चाहूँ कि नहीं. That is थोड़ा uncomfortable.
Having someone there.
क्योंकि यू डोंट नो व्हाट्स मतलब
बाउंड्री है
व्हाट्स अ बाउंड्री
क्या आया नवा
कोई एक नया ये आया अजीब है थोड़ा
इंटिमेसी कोऑर्डिनेटर
ये पंजाबी में
इंटिमेसी कोच होता है जो बताता है कि अगर एक फॉर एग्जांपल किसिंग सीक्वेंसेस है हो रहा है तो उसमें आप कितना किस करो कितना नहीं करो
लिमिटिंग इसलिए हो सकता है बिकॉज यू मे बी एंड यू एक्टर आर फीलिंग लाइक यू कैन गो टू अ प्लेस वेयर इट कुड बी
इट कैन साउंड थोड़ा सा
And अलग, हाँ. now you're restricted because you're given instruction.
But मैं ये नहीं बोलना चाह रहा था मैं कुछ
makes him very uncomfortable.
हाँ, no? ये ऐसा कुछ नहीं था मैं बोल रहा था मुझे ये breaking the ice I think. Sometimes कई बार नए सेट पे जाना और नई टीम के साथ जब काम करते हो तो वो मुझसे वो पर्सनली वो मेरा प्रॉब्लम है मैं शायद से ऐसे ज्यादा या तो मैसेज में बात नहीं कर पाता हूँ अपने डायरेक्टर्स के साथ उनको फील गुड ऐसे नहीं करवा सकता या आई डोंट नो हाउ टू चिट चैट एंड बी दैट कंफर्टेबल पर्सन मेक देम कंफर्टेबल एंड समटाइम्स वो ऐसा शायद से हो जाता है कि अरे नॉट एट ऑल बट शुरुआत में शायद स्टार्ट में When I know someone, then I'm फिर तो extrovert ही हो जाता
तब तक shoot खत्म हो जाता है
तब तक शायद देर हो जाती है बहुत तो
Who's the most interesting person that you've met in showbiz and why?
मेरा चांस क्यों है
जगुदा जैकी श्रॉफ It's like his Diwali wish was everything that I wanted. रॉकेट मत लगा कुत्ते का ध्यान रख
पौधे लगा
पौधे पौधे लगा
झाड़ लगा
साउंड मत कर ज्यादा धुआं मत उठा
दिस मैसेज ही सेंड यू
नो इट्स जस्ट दैट्स हिज दिवाली विश फॉर एवरीबॉडी एंड ही इज सच अ ब्यूटीफुल
पर्सन ही इज सो फुल ऑफ लव ही इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रॉकस्टार
लेसली कूल और माय बर्थडे गिव मी अ वीडियो कॉल ही इज इन सम सिटिंग पूल साइड शर्टलेस And he's like, "Wow, bachcha, tera happy birthday. Tera ko wish karne ke liye phone kiya." Like, too cool. That's it.
So cute.
So awesome, so man. He's the most fun person I've met in Bollywood. Sorry, apart from all these people.
Of course.
I just recently met Tabu in flesh, and oh my god, like I have not been starstruck.
Yeah.
You know, I remember. I was a bartender in New York. I met Danny DeVito. I met like big stars and they're really cool people. The thing about a really great star is they make you very comfortable and you don't feel like you're in the presence of something. Tabu, I think that's just, she has, there's so much enigma in her. She's so enigmatic. And the fact that I can't read her. I found myself blushing. In her presence and her body of work and she's so Amazonian, right? She's really tall. She has a very commanding presence and the language.
There is a mystery.
Speaks, that's a mystery.
There's a mystery.
And I think for me, the idea of, if at all you have to talk about being like a star, this whole idea of a persona larger than life, there has to be that. I shouldn't know everything because then I have to keep wanting to know more. And I think Tabu has that for me.
She still keeps that. Automatically.
Without being cold, she's very warm.
She's very fun to be.
Very fun to be with, yeah.
There's that mystery, there's something.
Yeah.
I would second that. I mean,
I would
for me also.
Achha, chalo. Tumne pehla wala answer
diya. I was at screening, Kala screening, and I remember you saw me.
Yeah.
It's like a gravitational pull.
That's true.
Tabu is there. You just, she also knows. Even Tripti knows. I just went, maneuvered myself around, and I just stood in front of Tabu, spoke in Hyderabadi with her, and then my life.
Yeah, there's a magnetic pull. Yeah. Like you find yourself suddenly, and then you're there, and then you have nothing. Like I couldn't say anything.
Correct. She's amazing.
I think for me, that person has to be Rumi Jaffrey. He's so full of stories. And I met him briefly in Masoori when I was shooting.
Con?
Rumi Jaffrey.
The writer, filmmaker,
Yeah, and he's just too funny. And I was meeting him for the first time, but I felt like I knew him from childhood. He was so warm and जो जो स्टोरीज उन्होंने मुझे सुनाई आई डोंट थिंक आई कैन टॉक अबाउट दोस स्टोरीज बट या ही इज द वन
नाइस राज
देयर टू पीपल आई वुड से वन इज शाहरुख सर मिस्टर शाहरुख खान आई नेवर मेट एनीबॉडी लाइक हिम
दैट्स ट्रू
द वे ही ट्रीट्स यू वी ऑल नो हिम द आई थिंक द ग्रेटेस्ट गाय आई थिंक वी ऑल लव हिम एंड अनदर वन इरफान सर And I met him a lot of times when he was there, but I met him when during his last days in London. And then we met for lunch, me, Anoop Singh, Hirfan sir, Shutapa ma'am. And I think that those 2-3 hours I would always cherish because that guy who knew, you know, what was coming and still the way he was portraying himself and he was still so curious about things, about life, he wanted to travel and he became very Sufi type. You know,
yeah,
very Sufi, very Sufiana. And of course, one of the, I don't think so there would be another Irfan Khan ever in this country.
Yeah.
Nope.
The biggest loss, I think, in the industry.
Gosh.
Yeah. Sorry, just to make it heavy, but yeah.
Nah, Irfan forever.
You made it real.
Yeah.
Yeah. Shefali?
Mr. Bachchan.
Yeah.
One is, I'm completely in awe of him.
Mm.
And even the first time I met him, you know, he treats you as an equal.
Yeah.
I remember once I was on the set of, I think, Aankhein, and I was sitting at the monitor and he saw the shot and he walked away and he came back and he said, what do you think of the shot? I died.
Yeah.
I was like, you're pulling my leg, right? I mean, you can't ask me what I thought of your shot. But that's who he is.
Yeah, yeah.
And he has a sense of humor.
Yeah.
And I think he genuinely cares. You know, he genuinely cares. And of course, I mean, what can I say about the actor
the
he is?
Yeah,
oof.
Work, yeah.
He's something else.
Yeah. My gosh, yeah. Paji?
Main wait kar raha hu paji ko.
Acha.
Haan ji, koi aisa mile.
Acha. Karte.
Main I think I'll again say Amitabh Bachchan sir and Shah Rukh sir. I think they really make you feel like you are the priority or you are you know the they are. जब भी वो आपसे बात कर रहे हैं तो वो पूरी तरह से आप ही से बात कर रहे हैं. उनका ध्यान कहीं और ये एक quality मैंने दोनों legendary actors हैं and उनमें देखी है जिस तरीके से वो आपके साथ रहते हैं. It's unbelievable. And I think I mean also I would like to say we are so lucky to be actually be surrounded by so many you know people
some
who are
iconic
who
people
have,
yeah
they're iconic and like Jackie Shroff sir ki baat kar rahe the Vijay ya Tabbu ma'am ya fir Amit ji ya Shahrukh sir all these people are just they're iconic and you imbibe a lot you learn a lot from them so yeah I've All these people for me, मेरे लिए ऐसा कुछ ऐसे मैं I would say इम्तियाज अली सर also for me. He's someone who's so Sufi, so you know he has that aura around him. Whenever you like, I really feel like कि मैं उनसे बस बात करता रहूँ और सुनता रहूँ.
You don't want him to stop.
You don't want him to stop. You want him to speak. बस बात करते रहो. So
Nice choices.
Jackie Shroff, I've already said here because he's just a definition of effortlessly cool, man. Yeah. Like, he doesn't try.
Real rock.
I remember him seeing him on a red carpet once where it was a black tie event. And he's walked in ripped jeans, leather jacket, and a kala rumal over here. So they were like, sir, black tie, man. Bidu, pehna toh hai black tie. That's Jackie Shroff. The other person who I was very lucky to spend time with is Pankaj Tripathi on the sets of 83. And
bahut badi aadmi hai, guru.
Bahut badi aadmi hai. And like, we were talking about social media and Instagram and I asked him how he deals with it and he said ek baat yaad rakhna charchit hone mein aur yaadgar hone mein zameen aasman ka farak hai.
I was like wow.
Nice. You know social media tumhe charchit kar dega but performance yaadgar. So I was like that's
a beautiful thing to say.
You know I want to ask all of you, there's a theory that you're defined by what you say no to, by the choices you don't make or the choices you make when you're, how have those decisions sort of defined you in your career? Do you feel like you've had some good dodges or that you've let go of things that...
So I should be null and void because I've said more no to... I mean, I've just said no all the time. And I don't regret it because I love what I do. So like, you know, when you'd asked about the script, I instinctively and at that moment fall in love with it, or that I feel, okay, this one's not for me. And if it's not for me, it's, I won't go and do it. I won't do enough justice to myself and neither to the director or the makers of the film. So, I mean, I have said no a lot.
A lot.
Me too. And I think I always go with my gut feeling. If upon reading the script, I don't feel like, oh God, this is something exciting, then I always say no. And I mean, it can put you in trouble. But I feel that's okay. And jitni bhi baar maine na bola hai, hamesha result, matlab I've felt okay, theek hai, achha gaya na bola. And because, you know, if, मुझे लगता है अगर मैं हाफ हार्टेडली, जैसे मैंने पहले भी बोला था, हाफ हार्टेडली जाऊंगी तो देयर इज नो पॉइंट इन मी डूइंग दैट पर्टिकुलर फिल्म, राइट? इट्स, आई कांट वेस्ट एनीबॉडी एल्सस टाइम. बट या
आई थिंक इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट टू से नो, एंड आल्सो इट्स वेरी टफ टू से नो.
या
समटाइम्स बिकॉज़ पीपल टेक यस वेरी हैप्पीली बट नो दे कांट रियली डाइजेस्ट समटाइम्स. आई हैव डन दैट टू फिल्म्स व्हिच हैव एंडेड अप बीइंग वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट सक्सेसेस ऑफ ऑल टाइम्स. And again, no regrets, because as she was saying, you know, there's no point doing something half-heartedly,
right?
Because somebody said, you know, अरे ये चलेगा.
Yeah.
Like the pandemic has taught me, I was never here to do things ki chalne ke liye. I started doing what I'm doing because I really fell in love with it. I really, as you know, Shefali ma'am was saying, I'm the happiest when I'm on set.
Yeah.
And that's everybody around me. They keep telling me that. So I think there's no point now. I've stopped thinking about क्या चलेगा क्या नहीं चलेगा. इसमें बहुत मजा आएगा, इससे बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिलेगा, इससे थोड़े ग्रोथ होगी एज एन एक्टर, और चल गया तो बहुत अच्छी बात है. नहीं तो प्रोड्यूसर को नुकसान नहीं हो रहा है ना. हाँ, नहीं हो रहा है, मैथ सही बैठ रही है, लेट्स डू इट.
या एंड आई फील एट टाइम्स यू कैन गो रॉन्ग आल्सो. मतलब आपने किसी को मना कर दिया एंड द फिल्म एंड्स अप बीइंग, या बट इट्स ओके बिकॉज एट द एंड ऑफ द डे इट वाज योर डिसीजन. यू विल ओनली ब्लेम योरसेल्फ एंड नॉट एनीबॉडी एल्स, एंड दैट्स ऑलवेज अ गुड प्लेस टू बी इन.
आई थिंक मेरे काफ़ी नोज किए हैं मैंने, और काफ़ी टाइमिंग भी गलत भी हुई है मेरी तो नो बोलने की, तो वो सब भी हुआ है. बट आई डोंट नो, आई डोंट रिग्रेट माई डिसीजन्स. एंड आई थिंक जो भी है, चाहे सही हुआ है लाइफ में चाहे गलत, वो सारे डिसीजन मेरे खुद के हैं. सो आई एम प्राउड ऑफ दैट जर्नी देन, मोर, इवन मोर, बिकॉज उसमें किसी ने मुझ पर कुछ थोपा नहीं है. सो So that is what वो matter करता है at the end of the day. और yeah, there have been instances जहाँ पर मैंने मना किए, और हाँ शायद से फिल्म चल गई होगी, या फिर, लेकिन मुझे पता है कि वो शायद से मेरे साथ वो चीज़ नहीं करती, या फिर वो भी बहुत सारी चीज़ें होती जो इन्वॉल्व होती. हाँ, मे बी आई वॉज नॉट राइट, मे बी समवन एल्स डिड इट वेल, एंड वो बहुत अच्छे होते उस फिल्म में. तो वो डिसीजंस भी बहुत कई बार ऐसे कैलकुलेशन, एंड मैं बस उससे अपने आप को मोटिवेट ही कर सकता हूँ कि यार मैं जो कर रहा हूँ वो सही है. अब अगर मैं अपने आप को भी सेल्फ डाउट करने लगूंगा तो दूसरा बिलीव करने तो पहले रुक जाएगा, अगर खुद ही करना छोड़ दूंगा. तो ये सारे डिसीजंस का वही खेल है. आई थिंक यस, वी ऑल ऑफ अस, आई थिंक वी से नो टू अ लॉट ऑफ स्टफ सो दैट जहाँ हैं हम वहाँ तक पहुँच पाए एटलीस्ट.
I've said no to films that I did once, a film in which I had to depict a rape scene. And after I did that, I realized I'll never do it again. Because ye ek balatkar ek aisi cheez hai that I don't think its representation is required in cinema unless it changes the way we look at the mind of the rapist. The fact that it's wrong, I don't need to see another film about it.
Right.
You know? So unless it's from a point of view of restorative justice, what makes a person commit such a heinous crime? There's some understanding of the damage that was done that leads to such a... I will never, as an actress, and in that scene when I was doing it only, I was like, this is so wrong. I'm never going to do this again. And I was very young and I didn't realize that what I'm doing. But so there are some things, there are some films I got where I will also say no to if a minority community is represented in a bad way. Even if your character is really good, but you make the husband, he is drunk, he is not faithful, and he happens to be Muslim.
You know, it may seem like, but my part is fine and it's all great, but I think we can't be tone deaf. We have to know what's going on around us. And I think ye dheere dheere ho raha hai, Rajiv, to understand ki it's not about just mujhe paise achhe mil rahe ki nahi, mera part achha hai ki nahi. But I think what is the intention? And also now I've asked, what is the source of the money? You know, somebody have the dodgy private investors and so yeah, I think these are some things. As one is growing, one is learning to, and no is powerful, like what you said, you know, Raj, to be able to say no is a very powerful thing. We sometimes, I've spent first 10 years being like, yeah, are you comfortable? Yeah. And they say, I'm not at all comfortable. Yeah, yes. You know, but learning to say, no, I don't like it. Yeah. So freeing. Saj bol diya, khatam. You know, so that also, you know, as you become more comfortable with yourself, then you can say it. So there are many things now that, but yeah, few ground rules that...
been set, right.
I need to pee really bad.
Me too.
I have literally one question after this.
That
was you saying no.
I have nothing to add.
Rajiv, I think we need
a break. Le le.
We have either a coffee shot or literally one question.
So, answer de de.
Are you in very bad shape or should we do the last?
He doesn't want to answer the question.
Should I give one really
long answer? Ya toh answer aayega ya toh pata nahi.
You need to go.
No, I mean, so saying no is part of the job that we do, actually.
Yeah.
Because it's just not the film. Sometimes within the shot, for a character, you're supposed to do something that you don't feel right. So learning to say no is the first skill set that you need to acquire once you start working as a professional actor. And you have to make peace with saying no. First with yourself and then learn how to communicate it as compassionately, as earnestly as you can. Yeah. And I've figured that people really get it if you come from the right place. Yeah. So, I... Or no ka, no bolne ke baad mein jo uska outcome hone wala hai, wo mujhe pata hi nahi.
It's not your control, yeah. Yeah.
No bolo, aage badho. Yes bol ke bhi aage badho.
Correct.
Move on to the next.
Aage badho.
Go to
the next. Bhaji? No. मैं क्वेश्चन भूल गया जी सर
नो नो बोले आपने मतलब कुछ
नहीं नहीं उनका सवाल था कि नो नो बोलना नो बोलने से आप का
या नहीं किसी को नहीं पता इधर इधर तो
आपने पिक्चरों को
मना किया है
हां जी बहुत बारी मना किया
बहुत ही बार
मना ही किया है क्योंकि वो हमारे पंजाब वो ना दिल में ले जाते हैं बात
बिल्कुल
कि ये तू कैसे मतलब हमको
कभी रिग्रेट किया है नो करना
नहीं वो तो डेस्टिनी है मतलब वो शायद आप नहीं करते तो कोई और बंदा करता है वो अच्छा ही करता है वो ऐसे ही होना ही होता है
जी
तो उससे ऐसे कोई वैसे तो नहीं फर्क पड़ता लेकिन ऑब्वियसली क्योंकि जहां से मैं आता हूं वहां से लोग पर्सनली बहुत अटैच होते हैं तो वो फिर आपके पूरे क्राफ्ट को वैसे ही सोचते हैं वो जो जैसे बोल रहे पाजी की 80s में शायद हम थैंकफुल हम 80s में नहीं है लेकिन हम जहां से आते हैं वहां से लोग हैं कि वो पर्सनल ले जाते हैं हम बात तो उस चीज के लिए नो बोलना ही पड़ता है
आई थिंक वो एक अलग क्राफ्ट है टू से नो
टैक्टफुली ना
बहुत टैक्टफुली कैसे नो बोलना एंड समटाइम्स इट्स जैसे तिलोत्तमा ने बोला कि वो इट्स फ्रीइंग सेइंग नो इज मतलब वो एक यू फील फ्री
करेक्ट
बट हां इट्स अ क्राफ्ट आई थिंक इट्स अ डिफरेंट बॉल गेम ऑल टुगेदर बिकॉज पीपल व्हेन दे आर ऑफरिंग यू समथिंग दे हैव रियली इन्वेस्टेड अ लॉट इन इट एंड दे थिंक कि दैट्स द बेस्ट प्रोडक्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू देम एंड तो उनके लिए सोचना ये थोड़ा सा मुश्किल हो जाता है कि कोई नो बोल रहा है
द ओनली थिंग दैट आई एम रियली माइंडफुल ऑफ व्हेन सेइंग नो ऑफ कोर्स यू हैव टू से नो व्हिच इज व्हाट एवरीवनस एग्रीड ऑन इज टू नॉट
कीप चलता रहेगा
मैं बहुत धीरे से बोल रहा हूं
धीरे धीरे बोलना थोड़ा और
हां तो मैं बोल
48 फ्रेंड्स में चला
आपका आंसर भी लंबा था इनको सुसु आया है इनका छोटा चाहिए
मैं भी वही सोचा
सर है ना जितनी दूर से इनको सुसु आया इनका आंसर छोटा चाहिए था
इन्होंने इतना लंबा आंसर दिया
I have to put my point across. Yeah, they didn't want to know.
Pehla point to achhe se across kiya.
Last one.
I was saying what I'm mindful of is don't keep the person waiting for too long.
Right.
If you're going to refuse it,
what I try, and this comes from experience, because I've been the person on the other side waiting.
Yeah.
And I know what waiting for a creative person feels like. So agar mana karna bhi hai, do din le lo, teen din le lo, maximum panch le lo, par mana kar do. It's, it, you know, don't keep someone hanging for 3 months and then refuse it. Is all.
Oh, yes,
yeah.
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 Speaking of waiting. I want to end by asking all of you this question. When a fan comes up to you, what is he or she most likely to say or to ask you, and what are they most likely to recognize you from?
छोटे बच्चे मेरे पास नहीं आते हैं ठीक है एंड आई एम नॉट कंप्लेनिंग
वेरी गुड यार
एकदम छोटे बच्चों वाला छोटा सा जवाब
डिफरेंट
पीपल कम फॉर डिफरेंट थिंग लाइक सम पीपल रियली लाइक न्यूटन सम लव लाइक किड्स एंड यंगर वंस लव थ्री सम लाइक गैंग्स ऑफ वासेपुर आल्सो फॉर सम रीजन कि शमशाद सर Shamshad jo hai na, like, are, aapko yaad hai Shamshad? So I think different people come for different things. But I know that Badhai Do, I've gotten a lot of love for Badhai Do, especially from the people within the community and their families. And people who were trying to come out but didn't have that much strength. I think our film gave them that strength. So Badhai Do also like got me a lot of love.
Shefali?
I agree with Raj. I mean, they all... people like different kind of stuff. I mean, some remember the first show I did. So that's, you know, it goes back to that.
Right.
When you're traveling or you're meeting people from across the globe, then Delhi Crime is the one that, because everyone's seen it and it's dropped on Netflix, et cetera, et cetera. But like, for example, a lot of people, Dil Dhadakne Do is their go-to film.
Yeah.
You know, when we want to just chill and have fun, we watch this film.
Yeah.
So it's various things. And either they ask you for a selfie, and I don't think they really are interested in anything besides just the selfie.
Right.
I don't, it's just like, you know, or then there are really some people who want to come and just appreciate or tell you how it's affected them in their in its own way. Yeah, but that's more like
okay.
It was Alice for 20 years.
Alice
for 20 years, and then Ratna, I think, from Sir. I think it's about numbers now, Raji.
Of course,
it just reached so many people that it became Ratna, and then Delhi Crime. I was in Delhi and buying kulfi and these three guys were looking at me and I had a feeling that, you know, they want to say something. And they were CBI officers. So they introduced me, we are CBI. I said, what? The kulfi is cold. I'm feeling cold. I was like, yeah, what did you say? No, Delhi Crime. I was like, acha. I was like, such a relief. Because, but they said that they're CBI officers, but they found it, you know, that part touched them.
Yeah.
And they were scared of Lata. So I was like, good, be scared. And so that was a nice, nice interaction and unusual to have these CBI officers come up to you and scare you, and then for you to realize, oh, it's the work.
Yeah.
Again, different people for different things. Mardani is the most often listening. Kids come for Chichore, and most recently, Ye Kali Kali Aankhein.
Of course.
Yeah.
Paji?
So fans, मुझे लगता है एक कमाल की उनकी दुनिया है.
जी.
आप सब हम काम कर रहे हैं अपने लिए. अपने आप अपने क्राफ्ट को दिखाने के लिए आप हमको गाना भी बनाते हैं या शोज भी करते हैं लेकिन उनको उनको पर्सनली कुछ चीज़ ऐसी नहीं मिल रही है कि उनकी लाइफ उस चीज़ से आगे बढ़ रही है आप वो इन्जॉय कर रहे हैं लेकिन कैसे वो आपके बारे में सोचते हैं आपकी आपके लिए पेज बनाते हैं आप पे बात करते हैं और ये कमाल कमाल की दुनिया है उनकी एक और मैं तो अमेज होता हूँ उनको देख के कि यार ये बंदे इनको कुछ नहीं लेना देना पर्सनली भी नहीं शायद कभी मिल पाएंगे या कोई शायद एक फोटो सेल्फी तो मतलब हाँ ये कैसे अपनी पूरी अपनी लाइफ डेडिकेट कर रहे हैं वो उस चीज को एंजॉय कर रहे हैं तो ये एक अलग दुनिया है फैंस की एक अलग दुनिया है बहुत बड़ी बात है किसी को ऐसे बिना जाने इतना प्यार करना बड़ी बात है.
बट पाजी आई वांट टू टेल यू वन थिंग कि हमारी मेरी शादी पे मैं और पतलेगा जब शाह एक साल पहले हमारी शादी हुई
अच्छा
आपका जो लवर गाना है ना
अच्छा
वो तीन दिन हमने इतना पागलपन वाला डांस मतलब मैं एक कोने में होता था पत्रा एक कोने में होती थी अगर वो बजा दिया डीजे ने तो हमें दूसरे को कहीं ना कहीं से ढूंढी लेते थे कि ये तो अपना गाना है यार इसमें तो हम डांस करेंगे तो थैंक यू पाजी
थैंक यू सर थैंक यू सर.
तृप्ति
I think I got a lot of love post Bulbul and very recently I was shooting in Meghalaya. I was there for a day and वहाँ पे I wasn't expecting कि किसी ने देखा होगा या होता है ना you don't expect it was a village area. And one girl walked up to me, she didn't ask for a picture, nothing. She just started talking to me about the film and what an impact it had on her personal life. And that just felt so amazing. And Laila Majnu bhi, matlab, it's been 4 years now. It came out in, I think, 2018. Record, aaj tak, every day I get messages from people for that particular film. Every single day. Ek bhi din aisa nahi hai, jis din mujhe Laila Majnu ke liye koi message nahi aaya hoga.
It's going to be kala for a while now. What a phenomenal performance.
Thank you.
Absolutely phenomenal.
Karthik? Now it must be all Roo Baba, no?
थैंकफुली मतलब मुझे ऐसा जिस तरीके का फैन लव अब तक मिला है वो बहुत अनप्रेसिडेंटेड सा मुझे बहुत अच्छा लगता है और मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि जिस तरीके की एक लॉयल फैन बेस बहुत मुश्किल से बनती है एंड मुझे लगा वो सोनू से बहुत ज़्यादा स्टार्ट हुआ था सोनू के टीटू की स्वीटी से तब पहली बार लोगों को मेरा एक्चुअल में नाम पता चला. उसके पहले वो मोनोलॉग वाला लड़का वो लंबे डायलॉग बोलता है वो वाला लड़का तो वैसे चलता रहता था बट सोनू के टीटू की स्वीटी घरों तक पहुंची और वहां से वो एक फ़ैन फॉलोइंग फ़ैन बेस पूरा एक चालू हुआ एंड उसके बाद ऑफकोर्स लुका छुपी पति पत्नी लेकिन अब जाके भूल भुलैया ने तो कुछ अलग ही लेवल का एक यूफोरिया क्रिएट किया विच आई एम लकी टू हैव दैट एंड मैं बहुत बार ये चीज़ बोला आई एम अ फैन ऑफ माई फैंस क्योंकि जिस तरीके से जैसे पाजी अभी बोल रहे थे कि वो जो एक अनकंडीशनल लव उनकी तरफ से आता है आपकी पोर्ट्रेट्स बनाते हैं आपको लुभाना चाहते हैं आपसे बात एक बार आपकी आंखों एक बार आपका एक गेज उन पर आ गया तो वो खुश हो जाते हैं सो इट्स अनरियल दैट लव एंड आई थिंक मुझे सबसे ज़्यादा सपोर्ट मेरे फैंस ने किया है आज तक सो आई होप कि मैं भी उनको ऐसे एंटरटेन करता रहूँ आगे तक बट इट्स रू बाबा नाउ या
वेल टू ऑल ऑफ यू मे दैट लव मे दैट फैन फॉलोइंग इंक्रीज थैंक यू सो मच फॉर दिस बट फर्स्ट रियली थैंक यू फॉर दोज वंडरफुल परफॉर्मेंसेज दैट यू नो दैट ब्रॉट जॉय इन आवर लाइव सम ऑफ देम broke our hearts but in a positive way made us think made us feel thank you for improving our lives through your art it's such a gift thank you for really entertaining us and for making us think for bringing happiness into our lives may you continue to do what you do may you continue to soar thank you so much for being a part of this
thank you
thank you
so much
thank you.